Okay, hello everyone, and welcome to our lecture on the Dasalan at Tuksohan under the course Readings in Philippine History. Okay, so what is the Dasalan at Tuksohan? Okay, so if you've read the reading, so we can see that it is a satirical work in the form of a catechism or a prayer booklet. Okay, so it's a work of satire, yeah, satirical work. Okay, mainly it's a satire that presents the issues in the society. Okay, so using wit, humor. Okay, as what all satires do. Okay, so the main topic or what the work centers on are prior activities and malpractices. Okay, as what you have read and as what we will show later, so yung mga examples ng mga sa work, okay, so yun nga, we can see how the author sees the activities of the friar or the actions of the friar based on how he presents it in his booklet. Now, who is the author? Okay, so the author is Marcelo H. Del Pilar. Okay, so I'm sure that you are familiar with the person. Okay, so just some little bits of background that may help us in analyzing or in interpreting or examining the reading. Okay, so yun nga. So much of what we know about Del Pilar was that he was one of the reformists. Okay, he was one of the members of the La Solidaridad. Okay, so he was one of those Filipinos, the ilustrados, who were in Spain and tried to struggle for reforms or tried to push for changes in the Philippines, right? Okay, so looking into a little bit of his story, so this is not the entire biography. Kunin lang natin yung mga significant anecdotes about Del Pilar. So one such anecdote is that he was sent to prison, okay, after questioning the excessive baptismal fee in a certain parish, I believe in Manila yata, if I'm not mistaken. Okay, so yun. So imagine na if you were Del Pilar, di ba? You were asking, di ba? You were inquiring, bakit ang taas-taas ng fee sa pagpapabinyag? Okay? Diba? Wherein nowadays, diba, pag magpapabinyag, it's not, well, lumalaki yung gastos because of the celebration or because of the reception. But the binyag itself, if you simply want the sacrament, diba, hindi naman siya ganun kataas. It really depends on the person or the parents of the person to be baptized, di ba? Okay, so yun. Anyway, so imagine si Del Pilar, tinatanong nyo lang, why is the fee for baptism so excessive? Okay, masyadong mahal. Okay, so nagtanong ka lang and then you were sent to prison. Okay? Alright. Okay, well, he was able to defend himself. Okay, so he was set free. All right. Okay, so another such anecdote was that his eldest brother was deported, okay, because of allegations of being one of the organizers in the 1872 Cavite Mutiny. In the Cavite Mutiny, this was also the event where the three priests, Gomez, Burgos, and Zamora, were also implicated. Okay, so dyan din sila na damay, dyan sila na accused of being organizers or instigators of the mutiny, hence they were executed. Okay, so ganun din, same reason with the brother of Del Pilar. Okay, so he was also accused of being one of the organizers. Okay, of course, we all know na he was involved in anti-friar activities. So after mass, so magbibigay siya ng mga pamphlets. Okay? He would speak in sa mga sabungan, cockfighting pits. Okay. So yun, so he would engage in speeches, in public speeches, public presentations, proclaiming anti-friar sentiments. Okay? All right. Okay, so again, so babalikan natin 'yan mamaya. All right. So, let's have some examples of the contents of the dasalan at tukson. Again, it's in a form of catechism. Kumbaga, if it's not a satire, kumbaga, yun lang, parang booklet of the basic prayers of the Catholic faith. Okay, so you have yun nga, yung basic beliefs, the fundamental beliefs rather, okay? So, tapos nandiyan yung mga fundamental prayers, Our Father, Hail Mary, My Glory Be, okay. Okay, so one such example of the satire is a satirical work on the Our Father, okay? Ama namin. So to read, so yun nga, so it's entitled Ang Amain Namin instead of Ama Namin. Excuse me. Okay. Amain namin, sumasakumbento ka. Excuse me. Okay. Sumpain ang ngalan mo. Malayo sa amin ang kasakiman mo. Kitlin ang liig mo dito sa lupa para nang sa langit. Saulan mo kami ngayon ng aming kaning iyong inaraw-araw at patawanin mo kami sa iyong pag-ungal para nang pagpapatawa mo kung kami nakukwaltahan. At huwag mo kaming ipahintulot sa iyong manunukso at iadya mo kami sa masama mong dila. Siya nawa. Alright. So let's have a look at how Del Pilar presented or how Del Pilar depicted the actions of the friars. Okay, first, ayan, sumasakumbento ka. So meaning, so yun. So he depicted the friars as priests who basically go to the convents sa mga madre and well you know. Okay? So yun ako nang ginagawin doon. All right. So that's one of the depictions that Del Pilar presented of priests. Okay, so they were individuals who went against their vows, okay, of celibacy. Okay, so imagine, of course, this is definitely scandalous even today if we hear of a priest who yun niya, who unceremoniously go to convents. Okay, yung bumibisita kapag gabi, ganyan. Alright, sumpain ang ngalan mo. Okay, so which shows their sentiments towards friars. Okay, malayo sa amin ang kasakiman mo. So, greediness. Okay, so friars were depicted by Del Pilar to be greedy. Okay, and meron pang iba dyan. Okay, that would strengthen his depiction of friars as greedy. Okay. So yan, yung kaning inaraw-araw nila. Okay. Pag sila ay kinakwaltahan. Okay. Ayan. Right. So yan. So friars in this work, in this first example, are depicted as immoral, greedy, and downright absurd individuals. Okay, na basically what sent the type of sentiment that he was wanting to manifest was that of basically was that of anger towards the friars, that of distrust. Kumbaga, what he was trying to achieve was to dissuade Okay, was try to put distrust, okay, to try to pull away the people, okay, from the influence of the friars. Okay, mainly, ayan, by telling them anong ugali meron ang mga friars. Okay? Yeah. Let's have another example. Okay, this is a parody of Ten Commandments. Okay, ang mga instead of the Lord's commandments, so it became mga utos ng fraile. Because apparently what Del Pilar wanted to portray was that the friars were practically lording over the colony. Okay? Now first, ano yung mga utos ng fraile? Sambahin mo ang fraile na lalo sa lahat. Okay? Huwag kang magpapahamak man ba ng ngalang diretsos. Mangiling ka sa fraile, lingguman at fiesta. Isang lamo ang katawan mo sa pagpapalibing sa ama't ina. Mainly because it was mentioned a while ago that the baptism fees were excessive, but it was not only the baptism fees. Basically, all church services that have to be paid are excessive. So yan, pagpapalibing. That's another example. Okay. So it's to the point wherein if you really want a family member to be given a Catholic burial, so as in kailangan, you have to sell your property. Okay, minsan kulang pa, so sometimes you have to undergo debt. Kailangan mangutang ka. All right. To strengthen that point, number 5, huwag kang mamamatay kung wala pang salaping panglibing. So again, yun nga. So don't let yourself die if you don't have the resources to afford a Christian burial. Okay? Huwag kang makiapid sa kaniyang asawa. So again, another portrayal of the friar that yeah, even though they have this vow of celibacy, okay, na people or they can see that the friars have their mistresses. Okay, huwag kang makinakaw. So, nagnanakaw daw yung fraile, so huwag kang sumawsaw. Okay, so just let him do the stealing or the robbing. Okay, huwag mo silang pagbibintangan kahit ka masinungalingan. Huwag mong ipagkait ang iyong asawa. Huwag mong itanggi ang iyong ari. Alright? So again, depicting friars as immoral individuals, diba, who go against the teachings, basically, who go against whatever they are preaching. Okay? And they go against, they're behaving against the vows that they took when they entered the priesthood. Okay? So nagnanakaw, how do we put this in a more lighter terms? And engaging in adulterous acts. Ayan. Alright, so itong 10 utos ng fraile, dalawa ang kinauuwian. Okay, so di ba remember Jesus summarized the 10 commandments into 2. Okay. So first, sambahin mo ang fraile lalo sa lahat. Ihayin mo sa kanya, mo naman sa kanya ang puri mo at kayamanan. Okay? So instead of love God above all else, it became praise the friars above all else. Okay? Then instead of love your neighbor as yourself, so you offer to the priests, okay, as you everything that you own. Okay, kayamanan and even your own dignity. All right. Okay. So how it's clear how the friars are being presented in this work, diba? You can clearly see the sentiment that Del Pilar is manifesting in his work. So it's clearly anti-friar. Okay? Kumbaga, he was trying to reveal to the people what the situation was, diba? That the friars are making themselves gods to the people in the colony. That's why he tried to make part, or he satired the prayers that the priests, that the friars were teaching to the people. Okay? Because it, well, for him, diba, it's a bit absurd na you're teaching or you're preaching to the people that you should love God and you should serve God, but the actions of the friars tell otherwise, that it's not God that you should love and that you should serve, but it's the friars that you should serve. Okay? And then yun nga, he specified those actions, diba, na which can be seen in the examples that we presented. Okay, now, there are other contents, but hindi natin isa-isahin. Okay? Alright, so, what makes Del Pilar, or what makes this source credible as a source? Okay? What makes us sure that this event, that these events happened? Alright? Okay. First, we can look into the background of Del Pilar, as what we said a while ago, na he experienced these abuses or these oppressions, di ba? Remember the anecdote about the baptism and the excessive baptismal fee, okay? And apparently, yun nga, not just the baptism but even the burial fees, etc. Okay. So he himself had experienced these actions of the friars, or these abuses, or these oppressions of the friars. Okay. Aside from that, we can also look into other writings or other sources of the time. What were they saying the same thing? Okay. So particularly, if you want other readings about friar actions, okay, you can look into the works of the other reformists. For example, Lopez Haina, diba, in his work Fray Botod, again, where he tried to depict a friar in pretty much more or less the same behavior, but it's a little bit more detailed. Kumbaga, doon kay Haina, there are situations talaga wherein he would show how the friar would behave in those specific situations. Okay. Another is, of course, we can also look into Rizal's works or Rizal's novels, how he gave descriptions to the friars in the novels, diba? Damaso, Sibila, Salvi. All right. And again, we can see parallelisms in how the friars are depicted, diba? They are, to sum it up, diba? They are, yun nga, as what we said a while ago, they are immoral friars, priests, okay, who do not practice whatever it is that they were preaching. Actually, it's hindi lang siya hindi nagpa-practice, but more so, they are, ang tawag dito, they're actually doing the opposite of what they were preaching, diba? Yun nga, bottom line, instead of they kept on saying to love and to serve the Lord, pero what they were actually behaving is that they wanted the people to love and serve them instead. Okay? All right. So, with that, what else can we say about the Dasalan at Toksohan? Okay, so if you have comments or clarifications, okay, so please, you can feel free to send me a message. Okay? And with that, okay, thank you. And I hope you learned something, and stay safe. always.